Decide, create, publish, repeat. That's how we roll. What is up, friends? Hope you are doing well. Before diving into the loop of greatness, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. And if you like this video, don't forget to share, hit the like button, and would love to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. So, decide, create, publish, repeat the process. That's how you learn coding. That's how you get from newbie to master. That's how you build those portfolio projects and get the job. That's how you become a freelancer or an entrepreneur. That's how you turn dreams into reality. Okay, that last one was a bit cringy. Decide, create, and publish. Not just once. Chances are you will have to repeat the process. How many times? I do not know. You define your personal condition for breaking out of the loop. Now, let's elaborate. First step is to decide what you want to create. Here's where you should give answers to some basic questions, such as why are you doing the project? What's the end goal? Is it, for example, for learning? Is it a hobby project? Is it to build a portfolio, to solve a problem, to make money? Is it all of the above? What's the time frame? Is there a deadline? Is it a hard or a soft deadline? What technologies are you going to use? After answering the questions, you will probably end up with a number of suitable project ideas. It is impossible to know beforehand, that is, before publishing, which idea is actually the optimal. However, you can go with the one that gets the highest score according to your priorities. Choose wisely. You are going to devote precious time building the project. Also, the more you believe in the value the project has to offer, the stronger the motive to overcome obstacles and keep going during the creation process. Which brings us to the second step, create. Here's where the magic happens, where you turn nothing, just an idea, into something. Here's where you put your technical as well as mental skills to the test. Here's where you extend your limits and grow. Even if you were to recreate the same project again and again, you would still get better each time. Here's where epiphanies occur and aha moments. Here's where you might get uncomfortable while learning and using new technologies. Embrace the process. Trust the process. Remember your motive, your why. Don't quit. And gradually, self-doubt will turn into self-confidence. Knowledge and experience is the gift, and hopefully a lovely project to share with the world. Which brings us to the next step. Publish. Share your project with the world. Sounds simple, but can be intimidating. Putting your work out there is like exposing part of yourself. You will probably come up with brilliant excuses for not publishing, or at least not yet. That's fear. Acknowledge it. It is your lizard brain taking over, warning you of dangers which, however, are not real, in the sense that publishing a project does not threaten your survival. So just ignore your lizard brain and publish the project. That way you will get feedback. You will see what works and what doesn't. This is the only way to realize the true potential of your project. You may publish a project with very low expectations and see it explode and have huge impact, or on the other hand, you may believe that you have the next big thing in your hands, only to realize after publishing that it is impossible to gain traction and people are simply not interested in the specific project. Before publishing, you can only make assumptions. So, publish your project, see what happens, and take it from there. Don't let your project just be one of the countless projects which live and die in our machines unshared and unmissed. In my computer alone, there are currently at least 20 unpublished projects as a result, of course, of at least 20 indisputable excuses for not publishing. I suppose I could publish some of them now, but I would have to go through the code base again and maybe even refactor the code. I don't believe I'm still making excuses. Anyway, the conclusion of this part is that you should publish your project. Just publish it. Don't be selfish, share it with the world. You worked for the project and did your best according to your current skill set. Of course, you could keep working and improving the specific project forever, and there would still be room for improvement. But you know what? Forget perfectionism. Your project is already good enough. Just put it out there. Excellent. So you took it all the way from conception to a finished project shared with the world. What's next? Repetition. As they say, repetition is the mother of all learning. It creates mastery. It is the key to success. So repeat the process. Get into the flow of making calculated decisions and executing, creating projects to share with the world. Try to keep the momentum going. But if for whatever reason you lose momentum, revert back to the essence of your journey, your motive, your why. Why did you get involved with this in the first place? What is the purpose behind all this? What do you want to achieve? And if your motive is strong enough, well, in this case, you better get back into the loop of greatness. ASAP. Back into deciding, creating, publishing, and repeating the process. Okay guys, that's all for now. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share it with anyone who might be interested. It would also be lovely if you join the journey, so please feel free to subscribe. For any questions, suggestions, or just to say hi, you can use the comment section below. Till next time, keep coding, keep improving, and enjoy the journey. Take care. Bye.